So let me just show you a few things about this EKG trace. Because in looking at an EKG trace, you can learn a lot about physiology and anatomy. So I'm going to go over here. I'm going to zoom in on this single EKG trace right here. And I do that by hitting this icon right here, which is zoom in. Now what you can see in this EKG trace is this little bump right here is called the P wave. And that is the depolarization of the atria of the heart. This large peak here is called the QRS complex. That is the depolarization of the ventricles. Once the ventricles have been depolarized, then the heart can actually pump blood. The heart then needs to repolarize, and that is this part here, which is called the T wave. And these are the key important things that most people are interested in when they're recording or looking at an EKG trace. They want to see the P wave, the QRS complex, and a good T wave. Now there's an even better way to look at an EKG trace, and this is what I would recommend if you're teaching STEM or you're teaching at college. What I'm going to do is just start completely over. So I'm going to say File, New. And this will take me back to the default EKG screen. Now, one of the things that you can do if you're recording an EKG is you can use something now in Logger Pro called a digital filter. What a digital filter is it's a way to clean up a trace, but by using software. So we use a special algorithm in the software to make that EKG trace look clean and actually to keep some of the key characteristics. That's to keep the QRS peak high and to do a few other things. But there's a couple things you need to know about it if you're going to use digital filtering with an EKG trace. Those key things are you need to sample a little bit faster and you need to open up a special file. And that file is located in a special folder. So if you go to File, Open, and if you go to the Experiments folder here once again, just scroll down until you get to the folder called Probes and Sensors. Now in this folder, there are a whole bunch of other folders for each sensor. We have special little files that are located in this folder. You want to go down and find the EKG folder. So I'm going to scroll down here and find, here's the EKG sensor folder, and I'm going to open that up. Now what we have here in this folder are several different files, and the one that I'm going to open up is called EKG with low pass parameter. What that is it's a special file that applies a low pass filter to the EKG trace. So I'm just going to open that up. Now in this file, it's going to record for 3 seconds. I have a little what we call parameter control down below, which I can use to set the low pass filter. And then this right here is the EKG that is filtered. So what you will see is the EKG trace after it has been, after a filter has been applied to it. An important thing to do as well, though, is I'm going to zero the EKG sensor before I record, and I'm going to increase the sampling rate. So to zero a sensor, that's not hard. All you need to do is go to the experiment drop-down menu and select zero. Then I'm going to go to the data collection button right here, and I'm going to increase my sampling rate to 500 samples a second. Now I'm just going to record an EKG trace again. So I'm going to cup this in my hand, I'm going to sit still, and I'm going to hit collect. There, and I'm done collecting. Now hopefully what you notice is that these EKG traces are much sharper. So the QRS complex is much taller and much sharper than it was in the other file that I showed you. You also might notice that the P wave is much taller and the T wave is much taller. What's really nice about digital filtering is once you've recorded the data, you can modify the filter and the data is still there. You don't have to record over again. So if I go down to this parameter control right here, and if I want to get rid of some of this noise, these little traces, all I have to do is decrease this number by clicking on this little arrow. And you'll see that what it does is it does decrease the peak height, but it also makes the trace look cleaner. And that looks like a nice EKG trace. So this is just another way to record an EKG to get a nice clean trace. And it actually adds some STEM features to it, because you can teach your students about digital filters and how to apply them.